Everybody, if you can hear my voice, raise your hand if you know someone who has been affected by gun violence. All right. Now, keep your hands raised. I want you to stand up if that's been a friend, loved one, or family member. Take a round the room. Take a look around the room real quick. This is why we are here. We are here. In my hand, I have a picture. I want everybody to take a look at this picture real closely. This is 15-year-old Hadia Pendleton. She was shot just weeks, days after attending Barack Obama's inauguration. We are here today to have a conversation about solutions. If you are here in this room today, this is no mistake. And I appreciate you, and we're gonna leave with some action items. Thank y'all. Just a quick history about what we're doing right here. This, as I said, is a collaboration between the League and brother Snoop Lion, who through his song No Guns Allowed featuring Drake and his teenage daughter Corey B inspired my organization, which is made up of young people of color, which we call non-college youth, many of them formerly incarcerated, to think more proactively about their lives and how to put the guns down. So I want to thank brother Snoop and throw to brother Snoop right now to give us a quick welcome.
Well, first of all, I want to thank y'all for coming out and being a part of this positive situation that we're trying to do right now. The reason why I made the song No Guns Allowed is because I'm just fed up with all of this gun violence. I've always, you know, had a problem with it, but you could never tell because I was always one to advocate and one to push and promote it. But once I seen, you know, public venues and little elementary schools being shot, you know, with innocent kids, it started to affect me to where it's like, this is just not a hood situation. This is an everyday situation, and we need to address it. So I felt like taking my music and using my strong point, which is my music, and making a song suggesting that we have no guns allowed tonight, and we take it one day at a time. So that's what today is about. That's what this whole movement is about. It's just trying to rid the world of violence one day at a time.
That's right. Give it up for him. Give it up for Brother Snoop. First question is to Uncle Snoop. I love the album, Reincarnated. And on my favorite song, No Guns Allowed, it says, let the music play. And I can't do this the right way, I'm gonna sound real corny. So I'm just gonna keep it how I talk. We don't want no more gunplay. When the bodies hit the ground, there's nothing left to say. We don't want to see no more innocent bloodshed. Me do not want to see more youth dead. And besides this important record, I know you for years have been bringing the artists on the West together after, you know, Tupac's death. And you've also combated violence to the Snoop Youth Football League. In your opinion, how have your important efforts kept the streets less violent, and how do we get other artists and celebrities to follow your lead?
Well, the Snoop Youth Football League is one of the main advocates of ridding the streets of violence, because what we do is we go into these communities where there's really no after-school programs, and we build these programs with the volunteers from the communities, and we give the kids a way to, you know, take that energy and put it in a positive manner. We have 8 chapters all over Southern California, and over the past 9 years, we've put over 200-300 kids through high school and over 150 kids through Division I with diplomas. So what we're doing, we're giving them another aspect of life, you know, because when I grew up, you know, gang banging and hustling, that was my superheroes. Those were my idols that I wanted to be like. So when I became successful, I started to take on that same, you know, role, but I felt like I should give the kids more than what I had. So I wanted to create something that had nothing to do with my music, and it was football, and it was the Snoop Youth Football League, and we rocking and we rolling, we saving lives. We got different gangs that don't even gangbang anymore because there's kids involved, there's cheerleaders, there's football players, there's volunteers, and it's saving lives.
Give Uncle Snoop a round of applause.
So there you have it from the BT Experience, but EsNewsReporting.com, I'm Elisa Back reporting.